Prostate cancer actually is the most common cause of cancer in men. Fortunately, most prostate cancers are not going to be a major problem for a man's survival. However, there are some that are dangerous. And so our job as urologic oncologists is to figure out which are the cancers that are dangerous and be able to treat those. It's really important to have all these different options, surgery, radiation, different ablation technologies, because the prostate is in a very challenging location. So anything that we are doing to treat a prostate cancer has the potential to impact urinary function, impact sexual function, and impact bowel function. Every man's cancer is different, and every man's priorities and approach to life and how to manage their cancer is different. My goal is to find that balance for each man of how to optimize their quality of life while giving them the best cancer control. Ablation technologies are this relatively new category of treatments which uses energy of some sort. You can use heat, cold, or electricity to really destroy the cancer cells. People who are interested in these focal therapies are really trying to mitigate a lot of those side effects that are associated with a prostate cancer treatment, and these ablation therapies are able to do that very often. It's a very interesting technology that we can control very precisely. We have a few different ablation technologies here at Yale that we can offer patients. One of them is the TULSA procedure. So it's a transurethral ultrasound ablation. So we are actually able to do the procedure inside an MRI scanner. The TULSA procedure allows for really excellent planning in terms of how we want to treat. We are treating the whole prostate, are we treating part of the prostate, really outlining where the edge of the prostate is in relation to those important structures, the urethra, the rectum, the nerve bundles, to really try to avoid damage to those areas. We also have other ablation technologies such as irreversible electroporation, which is a long name, but the short name is NanoKnife, which is the brand name. We also perform cryoablation, which is using cold or freezing energy to destroy prostate tissues. And I use these each differently. So we're very committed to evaluating these technologies and figure out what their role is going to be in the future, making sure that they're safe for our patients, making sure our patients have access to these newest technologies. We do actually have a randomized trial, which is very exciting because that's really our gold standard for evidence in medicine, is a clinically randomized trial. And that is looking at the TULSA procedure to ablate prostate cancer compared to radical prostatectomy or surgery. So we're really trying to evaluate, is there much of a difference in survival? Is there much of a difference in the time to recurrence of prostate cancer and the side effects? For men with intermediate risk prostate cancer, an ablation therapy is an option where you can get a treatment that is probably 80% at least effective compared to these gold standard treatments, with significantly less side effects that can help maximize their quality of life while still controlling their disease.